So hello, this is Dr. V.C. Sonthake, and I am the course faculty for this course, Engineering Thermodynamics. So objectives of today's video lecture are to explain basics of work and heat transfer, to define sign conventions for work and heat transfer, and to explain that work and heat are path function. Now, in the previous lecture, I have discussed and defined about energy from thermodynamics point of view. Energy from mechanics point of view is defined as the capacity to do work, whereas from thermodynamics point of view, it is not the work which is the effect of energy. It is heat as well, because heat and work are two different forms of energy. So from thermodynamics point of view, I define energy as the ability to put some efforts that can cause some changes, depending upon the condition under which those efforts are put. Cause can be either to produce heat, or cause can be produce some work transfer. We have also seen energy has two different forms. One is stored energy, that is energy possessed by the system within its boundary, and this energy does not cross the boundary of the system, like potential energy, kinetic energy, and internal energy. Then another form of energy is energy in transit or transient energy. And heat, work, and electrical energy are the examples of energy in transit. So in this lecture, I am going to concentrate on heat and work as two different forms of energy. Okay. So let us start our discussion with work transfer first. Definition of work and work transfer. So let us first define work. Let us consider a body, and a force F is applied, and when this body moves in the direction of application of force and travels a distance small d, so what do we say? Work is done by the force. So what is the mechanics concept of work? Work is done by the force F when it applies on the body, and because of that, the body moves in the direction of application of force. And we can calculate this force work W is equal to force into distance, and its unit is newton meter or joule. So this is the mechanics concept of work. Now what is thermodynamic concept of work? In order to understand the thermodynamics concept of work, let us say this is the generator. And it is generating electrical energy. Let's say it is in on condition. All of you have seen this generator. When you start this generator, it will give you electricity. Now this is also doing work, some sort of work. But if we apply the definition of work from mechanics point of view, there is no force actually, and there is no movement of the system itself. But still it is doing some work. So many times mechanics concept of work is not applicable in case of thermodynamics. So I would define work from thermodynamics point of view as well. Yes, it is Mechanics concept of work will also be applicable in many cases, but in some cases you will require thermodynamic definition of work or thermodynamic viewpoint of defining work. So in thermodynamics, work transfer is considered as to occur between system and surrounding. It is a boundary phenomenon. Now how work is defined in thermodynamics? Work is transferred or performed or said to be done by any thermodynamic system during a given process if the sole effect external to the system can be reduced to the raising of weight.
Okay.
What is the definition? Work is said to be done by the system if the sole effect of that work done by the system can be reduced to the raise of weight. In order to illustrate this definition, let me consider a thermodynamic system consisting of a battery driving the motor and this motor in turn driving this fan. And these are the system boundaries. And these are the system surrounding.
Okay.
So this entire battery plus motor I am considering as thermodynamic system. Now what is happening? This battery is driving this motor and this motor is ultimately driving the fan. So this, if I consider this as a thermodynamic system, some thermodynamic work has been done or has been or is being done here. But mechanics concept is not applicable because there is no force, there is no movement of system itself. But still I am saying some work is being done. So in order to satisfy the definition of thermodynamic work, I have taken this system. Now, what is being done here, the battery and motor as combined system are doing some work and the sole effect because of the doing of work can be reduced to drive the fan. Whereas what is the definition of work? Work is transferred or performed or said to be done by the system during a given process if the sole effect external to the system can be reduced to the raise of weight. What does it mean? Whatever work is done by this thermodynamic system, its effect can be reduced to raise of weight. So in order to satisfy this definition, I am little bit modifying this system. This is a battery, motor, system boundary and system surrounding. Please correct. Let me correct this. It is surrounding. And this is also surrounding. So, in the second case, what did I do? I replaced this fan with the help of pulley, this is pulley, and weight. Weight is suspended from this pulley by a thread.
Okay.
This is the thread. Now what it is being done here, whatever the work is produced by this battery and motor, as a thermodynamic system, the sole effect can be reduced to raise of weight. So due to work done by the battery and motor, this weight is being raised. So now I can say battery and motor is doing work. So this way I can define thermodynamic work. The sole effect of battery and motor external to its boundary can be reduced to raise of weight Then I can say battery and motor as a thermodynamic system is doing work. So that is thermodynamic concept of work actually. Now there is a sign convention for work transfer. Work done by the system or work output from the system is considered as positive. For example, let us consider this system. If So there is a sign convention for work transfer. Work done by the system or work output from the system is considered as positive. Let us consider the system. If work is done by the system or we are getting some work output from the system, then this work W is considered as positive. Examples of the thermodynamic systems which can give you work output or work is considered positive for them are turbine, engine, windmill. The meaning of work output means they can do work for you. Like turbine, all the turbines will rotate, they will drive the generator and ultimately it will generate electricity for you. Isn't it? Then engine. You feel, but you supply some fuel to the engine and it can do work for you. Windmill, it will also give you work output. So, work output from all this system will be positive. Or I can say work is done by these systems. On the other hand, work done on the system or work input to the system is considered as negative. Let's say this is the system and if you are supplying some work input to it, W, so this W will be considered as negative. For example, electric motor. In order to drive the electric motor, we give some electricity, that is electrical work input. Fan, it also requires electrical input. Pump, you have to supply electricity to drive it. Compressor, you supply electricity. So in all these devices, in order to do some useful work, you have to give electrical input. That is nothing but work as well. Work input to all these systems. That is why the work input to this system is considered as negative. Now here this sign convention is considered randomly. Considering the human psychology, it is our human psychology. Whosoever is doing work for us, we treat him or we consider him as positive. But if we have to help someone other, we don't like him. We treat him as a negative person. No, it requires my help. He is not a good friend. So in the same concept, the systems which are doing work for us, that is, they are giving work output, they will be treated as positive, or work output from them will be treated as positive. And the systems which require work input for their functioning, will be considered as negative work input device or work input will be considered as negative. Please remember this sign.
Yes, please.
Can you now? Now next concept is flow and non-flow process. These are very important processes in case of thermodynamic steady. So let us first define non-Brillouin process. Any thermodynamic process in which mass does not cross the system boundary is called a non-Brillouin process. It is also the process which takes place in the closed system. So any process which takes place inside a closed system is called as non-Brillouin process. Now once again here definition of process. When a system undergoes a change of state and the path of the change of state is specified, it is called as a process. So when does process take place? When there is a change of state. When change of state will take place? When there is a change in properties.
Okay.
So in case of non-Brillouin process, though there occurs change of state, there occurs change in property, but during this process, mass does not cross the system boundary. It remains within the system. For example, let us consider a piston cylinder arrangement containing some gas.
Okay.
Now if you supply heat to this gas, let's say initially the temperature of the gas volume and temperature is P1, T1. And let's say it exists in state 1. Now we supply some heat Q to this gas because of which it will expand, it will exert some force on this piston, it will move in the rightward direction. So because of the movement of this piston, it will do some work W. And it will stay. So its pressure, volume and temperature is also changing. So it will shift to a new state. So what has happened here? Because of change of state, process has occurred or process has taken place. But during this entire process, mass of the gas is not crossing the system boundary. Though process is taking place by undergoing change of state. So this process is called as non-Brillouin process. And if you remember, this is nothing but closed system. Because no mass transfer is taking place, only energy transfer in the form of heat input and work output is occurring. So process which is taking place in the closed system is also called as non-Brillouin process. Then flow process. A thermodynamic process in which mass crosses the system boundary during the process is called flow process. It is the process which takes place in the open system. For example, pipe flow. If water is entering at state 1 and it is leaving at state 2, it is undergoing change of state by undergoing change in the pressure or its velocity. So it is undergoing a process, and during the process, water as a system, as a mass, can cross the system boundary. Okay. So this is a flow process. And here, mass can cross the system boundary as well as energy can cross the system boundary. So it is nothing but open system. So any process which takes place in the open system is called as flow process. So based upon the definition of flow process and non-flow process, I can define flow work and non-flow work. So non-flow work done during non-flow process is called as non-flow work. Or work done by the closed system is called as non-flow work. So if this closed system is doing any work like here, it is W, this will be non-flow work. What is flow work? Work done in flow process is called as flow work. Or work done by the open system is called the flow work. For example, work done by the turbine will be called as a flow work. Because what is happening in turbine? Let's say water turbine. Water is entering, high pressure water is entering, low pressure water is leaving. Correct? So mass transfer is taking place and pressure energy of water is converted into work. And energy transfer is also taking place. So that is why work done by the turbine will be called as a flow work. So you please remember this concept of flow process and non-flow process, and flow work and non-flow work. Now next one is, now let me derive one relationship for work done by quasi-static process or quasi-equilibrium process or PDV work or displacement work or reversible work or non-flow work. Whatever derivation I am going to do, an expression of work done I will get, it is applicable for all these types of process. I am once again reading it, keeping in mind it's important. Work done by quasi-static process, quasi-equilibrium process or PDV work or displacement work or reversible work or non-flow work. Okay. So in order to derive that relation, let us consider a piston cylinder arrangement containing some gas.
Okay.
The gas is of known mass M, and initially its pressure, volume and temperature is P1, V1, T1. So let's say initially it exists in the state 1. Now we supply some heat input Q to this, because of which the gas will expand and piston will switch to the new position. And at this point, its pressure is P2, volume is V2, and temperature is T2. Let's say this is state 2. So what it has been done? Closed system has undergone some change of state. Closed system has undergone a process. And by undergoing the process, it is doing some work W. Let's say 1, 2. Now work is a path function as, let's say initial state of this system is represented by P1, V1, T1, and final state 2 is represented by pressure, volume and temperature P2, V2, T2.
Okay.
And since I am considering it as a process occurring in the closed system, or I am considering the process taking place in infinitesimally slowly, so this can be a quasi-static process, I can represent it by a continuous line. Let us consider at some point, at some intermediate point here, the pressure of the system is P. Pressure of the gas is P. And change in the volume is dV. This point can be anything. Because at state 1, I know all the properties P1, V1, T1. At state 2, I know all the properties P2, V2, T2. But at this intermediate point, I don't know what will be its pressure P. And let's say the change in volume is dV. And this change in volume is infinitesimal. That means very, very small. So what my sole aim, when this closed system is undergoing process, it is producing some work. So my intention is to get expression to calculate this work done. So when this piston moves infinitesimal distance, let's say the distance moved by this piston is dl. So due to infinitesimal piston movement dl, the piston will do some work. So infinitesimal work done due to infinitesimal piston movement, dw is equal to f into dl. Now here I am applying the mechanics concept of work. When force F is applied, by the gas on the piston, and it moves DL in the direction of application of force, and that distance DL is very, very small. So work done by the gas will be very, very small in infinitesimal. How can I calculate that work done? dW is equal to F into dL. Or dW is equal to P into A into dL, where A is the piston area and P is gas pressure. Okay. Or dW is equal to P into dV, where what is dV? It is equal to A into dL. And this is infinitesimal displacement volume. Okay. So, see, what is this dW is equal to PdV? When the gas is exerting pressure P on the piston, and because of that pressure, the piston volume is changing infinitesimally, dV, how much work will be done by the gas? This much. dW is equal to PdV. Now I am interested total work done during the process 1, 2, 2. This is the work done during this process only. From change of volume from small dV. But I want to calculate net work done by this closed system if it is undergoing change of state from 1 to 2. What will be that net work done? I have to integrate this. W12 is equal to integration of dW is equal to integration of PdV. And this work done is nothing but area under the curve. Now this is something very important relation we have got. So W12 is equal to integration of PdV is nothing but work done by during a quasi-static process or quasi-equilibrium process or PdV work or displacement work or reversible work or non-control work or work done by the closed system. And mathematically, I can represent this W12 is equal to integration of PdV by this area under the curve. Okay. If a system is undergoing a quasi-static process or if a closed system is undergoing a process, work done by the closed system or during that process is represented by area under this curve. So how much work the system has done? This much. 1, 2, V2, V1. So please remember, work done during all these conditions, expression is W12 is equal to integration of PdV, where P is any unknown pressure, intermediate pressure. We have to find this P and dV is change in the volume. Mathematically and graphically, this expression integration of PdV represents area under the curve during the process 1, 2. So kindly remember this expression. Now we have to prove that work transfer is a path function. Path function means any quantity whose value depends upon the path followed by the system during change of state. So we have to prove work transfer is a path function. So let us consider a closed system in the form of cylinder and piston. Initially, it is at state 1. Let's say this is state 1 and then it is moved to this state 2. So it has undergone a process. Okay. The piston cylinder has moved from state 1 to 2 and has undergone a process. Now, If I want to calculate how much work the system has done I have to represent this process on PV chart. Now let's say the system can undergo from state 1 to 2 by following different paths. So I am drawing these three paths. Let's say this is path A, path B, and path C.
Okay.
Now if I want to calculate work done by this system under consideration, what I have to do? I have to calculate area under the curve by following the path A. This will be the work done during the path A. Similarly, area in order to calculate work done during the process by following the path B, I have to calculate area under the curve.
Okay. This will be work done by following the path B, process 1 to 2. And finally, I have to find out the area under the curve C by following the path C. 1 to 2. Please represent the direction of process. Direction of process is very important in this case.
Now, by seeing these three curves, you can easily say area under the curve A is less than area under curve B is less than area C. So what does it mean? Area under the curve on PV diagram represents work done by the system during that process. And area under the curve A is less than area under the curve B is less than area under the curve C. What does it mean? WA is less than WB is less than WC. That means system is undergoing a process from state 1 to 2 by following three different paths. But area under the curve is different, so as work done by the system during the process 1 to 2 will be different if it follows the different path. That is, work done depends upon the path followed by the system, not by the end properties. That is why work transfer is path function. So this way you can prove in examination you have to explain this way. So that shows that work transfer is a path function. 1 to 2, isn't it? What is pressure at point 1? P1. What is pressure at point 2? P2. P2 is greater than P1.
Okay.
So, this is when final pressure is more than initial pressure. This process is called as, can someone suggest me? It is called as compression process. And if P2 is less than P1, it is called as expansion process. Let me, what I was trying to explain is this. Let's say this is pressure volume diagram. Let's say this is initial state 1, and at this state pressure is P1 and volume is V1. Forget about temperature at this moment.
Okay.
Now it undergoes a process from 1 to 2, and this is state, pressure is P2, volume is V2. Now in above case, P2 is less than P1 and V2 is greater than V1. So, and direction of process is from 1 to 2. So this process is called as expansion process. And work done will be positive here. Work done in an expansion process is always positive. That means it is a work output. But on the other hand, if let's say this was the initial state of a system, pressure P1, volume V1. And process is taking place in this direction. This is P2 and this is V2. Now what is the case here? P2 is greater than P1 and V2 is less than V1. This process is called as compression process. And work transfer will be negative here.
Okay.
Expansion process takes place in turbine, where pressure is reduced, volume of the gas is increased, and due to expansion in the turbine, work output is produced by the turbine. That is positive work output. Compression process takes place in compressor, where air at atmospheric pressure is sucked, whose pressure P1 is less, and its pressure is increased to P2 value, which is very, very higher. Volume of the air is reduced during compression process. And you know, in order to run the compressor, we give some electrical input. So work transfer will be negative. That is why work transfer is negative in case of compression process. So you please remember this. One more term you remember. Here, one term comes into picture. Expansion ratio. It is defined as the value of larger volume to the smaller volume. V2 by V1. Similarly, compression ratio will be, always larger to the smaller. In case of compression, initial volume is more, final volume is less. Okay, so this way you remember. In case of expansion, final volume will be more, so expansion ratio will be larger volume to the smaller volume, V2 by V1. In case of compression, initial volume will be more, so compression ratio will be larger to the smaller V1 by V2. Correct? So remember these terms. I hope it is clear to you. So all these concepts we are going to use in numerical. Then heat transfer. Like work transfer, heat transfer is also an energy in transit. So when energy is called as a work, when the sole effect external to the system is used to raise a weight, then energy transfer is called as work transfer. Now how to define heat? Heat is defined as the form of energy that is transferred across the system boundary by virtue of its temperature difference. Like work transfer, heat transfer is also a form of energy in transit or transit energy. It is also a boundary phenomenon, since it occurs only at boundary of the system, and heat can also cross the system boundary. That is why it is called as energy in transit. Energy transfer by virtue of temperature difference only is called heat transfer. All other energy interactions may be termed as work transfer. Now, in a similar way, I can define work transfer is a path function. Okay. So let's say at this point, the system is having pressure V1, volume V1 and temperature T1. Now, the plot has been changed. It is temperature entropy diagram. In case of work transfer, I have considered pressure volume diagram. So if a process can be represented on temperature entropy diagram, initial state 1, final state 2, so area under the curve on this diagram, temperature entropy diagram, represents heat transfer during the process. Okay, and it can be calculated as Q1 to 2 is equal to integration of infinite decimal heat transfer integrated over 1 to 2, state 1 to 2, and it can be given as T into dx, where x is called as entropy. So, in this similar tune, what we have proved work transfer is a path function, we can also prove heat transfer is also a path function. Because heat transfer during the process 1 to 2 will be different for the path followed by the system. Different path followed by the system. Okay. As the area will change, heat transfer will also change. So heat transfer also depends upon the path followed by the system. Okay. Now here also there is a sign convention for heat transfer. This is very important once again. If this is a system and if heat is supplied to the system, it is considered as positive, and heat removed from the system is considered as negative. So this sign convention is just opposite to the sign convention for work transfer. If you are giving work input to the system, it is considered as negative. If you are giving work output from the system, it is considered as positive. So please remember this sign convention. If you are giving heat input to the system, it is work positive. If heat is removed from the system, it is considered as negative. If you are supplying work input to the system, it is considered as negative. If you are getting work output from the system, it is considered as positive. Now let us have some basic terms related with the heat transfer. Adiabatic process. Any process in which there is no heat transfer is called as adiabatic process. That is heat. The amount of heat remains constant during that process. No change in heat transfer or no change in heat content, it is called as adiabatic process. The wall medium or system which does not allow heat transfer to take place is called adiabatic wall medium or system. For example, thermocol is the example of adiabatic wall. It does not allow heat to leave or enter across it. Thermocol, glass wool or all adiabatic medium. Diathermic process. Any process in which heat transfer takes place is called diathermic process. any wall, medium or system which allows heat transfer to take place is called diathermic wall, medium or system. For example, a steel wall, it will allow heat transfer across it, so it is a diathermic wall. A specific heat required to change the temperature of system by unit degree is called a specific heat. It is represented by C, and its unit is joule per kg per Kelvin or joule per kg per degree Celsius. Water is having highest specific heat. That is, if you are supplying some heat to the system and it is causing its temperature change only by unit degree, then that will be a specific heat. Sensible heat. When heat transfer takes place and that heat transfer causes change in the temperature without change in the phase of the system, it is called as sensible heat. Latent heat. When amount of heat transfer to the system causes change in the phase without change in its temperature, is called latent heat. Now there are three types of latent heat. Latent heat of vaporization, required to change phase from liquid to vapor. Latent heat of sublimation, will require to change the phase from solid to liquid. And latent heat of condensation will require change of phase from vapor to liquid. So these terms will be frequently encountered while doing some thermodynamics study. And these are basic terms. Please remember them. So after watching this video, you will be able to define basics of work and heat transfer, able to define sign conventions for work and heat transfer, and able to prove that work and heat are path function. So with this, I come to an end of this lecture. Thank you for your kind attention, passionate listening, and enthusiastically asking the questions. Happy learning.